We looked at the general addition rule, so now let's take a moment and look at the general multiplication rule. Given two events labeled A and B, the probability that they both occur, this is joint probability, is given by the probability of B times the probability of A given B. Now, this comes directly from this conditional probability. And obviously, I can turn this around, which I will in just a moment, and show there's another way of doing it. So the probability of A given B equals the probability of A and B times the probability of B. What I want is this. So if I multiply both sides by the probability of B, I'm just whipping a little algebra on it, that cancels out, and this is that statement. Now, obviously, I could also do this as the probability of B given A equals the probability of B and A divided by the probability of A, which implies the probability of A times the probability of B given A equals the probability of B and A. Because obviously the probability of B and A, this got to be the same as the probability of A and B. It's just saying the same thing two different ways. So I could calculate it either way. But need to keep them straight because it depends on what you're conditioning on. Okay, for the special case of independence, this specifies, or actually it simplifies, the probability of A and B is probability of B times the probability of A. And actually, I've already discussed that, and I explained why that's true. But just briefly, I'll do it again. Well, let's expand on this just for a moment. The probability of A and B, we already said, is the probability of B times the probability of A given B. Well, if they're independent, then A given B is the same thing as the probability of A. That's what led me to this. So, let's go back to this. Let's find the probability of a freshman and option B. Well, off of a table, this is really very fast and direct. So here's freshman. Here's option B. The and is right there, so I know the answer is going to be 10 out of 60, which is obviously 1 out of 6, and I could reduce it to a decimal if I want to. But let's use this. Let's use this rule up here. So the probability of a freshman and option B is going to be equal to, go back up here if you don't recall. There we go. B times the probability of A given B. So this is the probability of B times the probability of F, the freshman, given B. Well, the probability of option B is 40 out of 60. The probability of a freshman given B, well, given B happened, I'm right here. The probability of a freshman is 10 out of 40. And you see the 40s cancel, and I end up with 10 out of 60. Now, why did I go through all this when I could have just easily read it off the table? Because you don't always have a table to work with. You need to understand how these probabilities work. You may have another way of finding this probability and another way of finding this probability, and you don't have a table available to you. So given count data like this in a tabular format, finding conditional probabilities or joint probabilities is extremely simple. It's just wham, bam, straight to the point. If you don't have a table and you're giving these pieces of information, then you need to use the idea of independence, mutually exclusive, the general addition rule, and now the general multiplication rule. Use all these combined to find particular probabilities of events that you're interested in.